2 o'clock in Philadelphia, and time for the best show ever. Now, your starting lineup. Bring in the heat, Ricky. Bo. The Fanatic, Philadelphia.
Good afternoon, everybody. Oh, good afternoon. Best show ever here on 97.5 The Fanatic and NBC Sports Philadelphia. The phone number 610-632-0975. You know, I don't know if I've ever been this sports happy in my life in a regular season, so let's get right to our opening statements. We start with the word of the day. One of my favorite words, the word of the day today is glorious, because that's what's going on with the Eagles right now. Boy, you go up there to the Meadowlands, all that blue, and they end up feeling blue as the Eagles smack that team around. Not for a single moment was there a chance that the Eagles could lose that game. And the feeling, the team, everything right now, the vibes, all of it, glorious. Can you imagine in the beginning of the year? Let's go back to the beginning of the year for just one moment. When we're saying we haven't seen the team in preseason, which we did. We only saw one drive. And we have question marks. How much better will Jalen Hurts be? What kind of year and how healthy will Miles Sanders be? Remember, Kelce had surgery in the preseason. How will the center, will he be back? Oh, will the new-look defense, will Gannon get better? All of those things that we were worried about in the beginning. And now the team sits 12-1, and they smacked around those stinking Giants. And then people were trying to change the name of the Giants. No, leave the Giants. They beat the Giants. That's a football team that's really well coached. You couldn't tell by watching them. But believe it or not, that coach is really good at his job. They actually have more good players on that team this year than they did last year when they beat the Eagles. They're better. It's just the Eagles have gotten so much better. The quarterback, the coaching, the running back, the wide receivers, the offensive line, the defensive line, everything. And what about that gauntlet of running backs? Now that it's allegedly over, that gauntlet of tough running backs in which the Eagles beat all of them. None of them got 100 yards. None of them had a good game. The gauntlet, the Washington game. You know what that means. That's the blueprint. And now we're sitting here in just a sea of glory. As far as regular season goes, we know that there is still business to be taken care of out there in Arizona later. But we're not there. We don't have a time machine. Based on regular season, which is where we are right now, in the here and now, we can't worry about the past. We can't worry about the future. We can only worry about the here and now. It does not get any more glorious than it gets right now when you have a football team that's not just good. No. That would be disrespectful. It would be like calling a prime Halle Berry pretty. Like if that's the only word you can do. Or cute. Like to say the Eagles are good would be like saying prime Halle Berry was just cute. Good, that way better than good. The quarterback's the league MVP. 1,000-yard running back, 1,000-yard wide receiver, 10 rushing touchdowns for Hurts to go with it, 22-3 touchdown to interception ratio. Then you add another 10 more on top of that. Miles Sanders, double-digit touchdowns. I mean, can you imagine a time like it does not get any better than this? And I want us to do something that we're not used to doing. Enjoy it. Breathe it in. It smells good. Breathe it in. There's no smog in that air. There's nothing bad going on right now with your football team, and it feels just fantastic. It's glorious right now, and I want to discuss it today, not looking for problems, not looking for issues. No. We're going to do something we're not used to doing. we're going to have a good time with all this success and give credit to the people individually and collectively for how good they are right now. Good, nay, good, great, glorious even. I have never felt this good. And that includes the Super Bowl year. This includes any year with Five and Andy Reid. This is as good as it can possibly get in the regular season. Hunter Brody, I mean, how do you feel on this Monday?
Before Jalen Hurts even touched the football, Daniel Jones is getting crushed by Josh Sweat, by Hassan Reddick, and that set the tone. It's going to be a long day, dude. And you got Marcus Epps making tackles out in the flat. TJ Edwards is saying, you got nothing. It's amazing what this team does, and they just smash them. I know we like to go back to 2017 and relate this team to that team and look at certain things throughout the schedule. We always bring up Carolina because that was sort of that game that switched everyone's view. Well, then Denver happened, and they put up 51, and they obliterated that team. This feels like the Denver one. You're rolling at the right time. It's week after week. You're putting up an obnoxious amount of numbers. Your offense is soaring. And there was a lot that happened that was sexy yesterday. For example, 4th and 7, you get the beauty of a play by Jalen Hurts and Devontae Smith for a touchdown. But there's so much other stuff that goes on before they had the massive lead when it was 21-0 after taking advantage of whatever you want to call that punt by New York. But it was 3rd and 6 to Devontae as he's running to the sidelines. It was a 3rd and 3 to Quez Watkins. He's standing in the pocket. He sees there's someone coming his way. It doesn't matter. He still makes the throw to the left side of the field as Quez is going to the sideline. It's these third downs, and it's perfect every single time. Later on, it was 3rd, and he used his legs to keep the chains moving. Jalen Hurts, the best visual was when he was on the sidelines with Quez, with Devontae, and with A.J. Brown. Quez is throwing up money, celebrating, and Jalen Hurts is just locked in. I've never seen an athlete perform this high and also have that killer attitude. It's ridiculous, and I love every second.
He does it in different ways every single time he's out on the field. And I'm going to say this, because this to me, like in my lifetime, I saw a lot of good offenses. The one offense that I would even compare this to, and this one might even be better, was the greatest show on turf of the Rams. And that was of the St. Louis Rams when they had Kurt Warner, Marshall Faulk, and everybody and their brother. But what this guy could do different in Jalen Hurts, think about this. Right at the beginning of the game yesterday, make sure he hits his tight ends. I mean, hits Calcaterra, he hits Stoll later on. He uses every single weapon that he has, and it doesn't even have to be his legs. He used his legs. I wouldn't say he used his legs a lot yesterday. Used them when necessary, found the holes when they were open. This guy is your National Football League MVP. In my opinion, I don't care. Look around. You could put up any other quarterback that you want to throw up there. Tua did not have a great week this past week. Mahomes threw for 3 interceptions against the Denver team. I think Jalen Hurts has grown about as much as you possibly can grow in one season as a quarterback. And you seem to sit there and think, I mean, we'll sit here and look for words to describe this offense. The only word that I could even come up with is just incredible. Everything they do is spot on.
Glorious.
And glorious works for me. Glorious works for me, too. I look at this in a lot of different ways. You look at Miles Sanders having a monster season, over 1,000 yards, over, you know, the touchdowns this year. He had none. What, do you have none last year? That's unbelievable. Jalen Hurts doing it with his legs, doing it with his arm. But spreading the wealth is the main thing about being a good offense. And they're... For that being said, you look at the defensive side, and now all of a sudden the defense is a beast in the NFL. So, I mean, on both sides of the football right now, besides a punt mishap, I think this team is well on their way to Arizona.
This is glorious, and we have to find a way to enjoy it because it's not natural for us. Sometimes I say one of the good things about having a spouse in real life is they will sometimes take you out of your comfort zone because no married man can do everything he wants. He's going to have to do things that she wants. And the odds are you're not familiar with those things. Hunter, you've been married about 5 seconds. I'm sure there's some things that you may not have wanted to do, and some of them you will end up liking along the way. Some you won't, or television shows and stuff. Think of the Eagles as your perfect wife, 12-1, dominating. And all you have to do is get out of your comfort zone and enjoy how glorious it is. And they're getting healthier. It turns out Lane Johnson's okay. We don't know about Sipos. I do hope he's okay. But if he's not okay, he needs to have a press conference and be grilled as to why he couldn't hold. But either way, this is glorious outside of him. Glorious. We have to be able to enjoy it. People last week, I'm not up for the Giants game because I know they're going to win. So when you were a kid and your parents told you you were going to Disney World, you didn't get excited ahead of time? Because I know I did.
Enjoy the awesomeness.
Right. Have a good time with it, folks, because you've been living here. I don't care if you're 8 years old or 80. It's never been this good before. Enjoy it. 610-632-0975. We're going to talk to we'll have Sirianni's press conference at 2:45. Hopefully he'll give us an injury update. The odds are maybe 1%. We'll talk to Parrott Brooks from NBC Sports Philadelphia at 4:33 and Jeff Mosher in studio at 5:33 and a lot more today here on 97.5 The Fanatic and NBC Sports Philadelphia. And now time to start the Twitter poll with Jed Scordo. Hello, Jed.
Hello there. Will the Eagles go 16-1 this season?
Oh.
Easy yes or no answer. Right now, early votes has no winning at 68%.
Okay.
No, I don't think that that's because of fear that they're going to be
resting players,
yeah,
perhaps.
That, exactly. Yeah. The last week, maybe there's something to be said about where you are in the last week. And you kind of rest up. Or maybe this trap game coming up in between two division opponents.
Yeah. I tell you what, I'm not ruling it out, though.
Me neither.
I'm not ruling it out.
They could still beat the Giants with Gardner Minshew. Maybe even Ian Book.
Well, he played at Notre Dame.
Yeah, so you're right. No, real Notre Dame fan brings him up, right?
Yeah, not Ian Book, but with Minshew Mania, maybe. But that Giants team going in, this is the thing that's cute. I find this cute. Oh, day ball and da-da-da-da-da going into the game. Then, oh, they can keep it close. Maybe the Eagles only win by a touchdown. Then when they smack that team around, then it's, oh, they're under-talented. Oh, it's this or that. See, this keeps on happening, where the Eagles make a team look worse than they really are. And rather than give credit to the Eagles for making a good team look bad, like they did Minnesota, for example, instead they have to now reduce the level of the competition because it couldn't possibly be that the Eagles are that damn good. But that's what it is. This is a glorious football team. That's a pleasure to watch. Honestly, if Sirianni would just do something different with his press conferences, there would literally be nothing left to complain about. And the only reason the press conference thing matters is he goes so long saying nothing.
Yeah, no doubt. They have been saying this since the Eagles were 6-0, 7-0. Uh-huh. And then now every single time it's because the opponent. But speaking of what's cute, you know what else is cute?
What's that?
The fact that the Dallas Cowboys, after the game is over, right? I mean, they had to sneak away with one. They're worried about who gets credit for an interception while the Eagles are getting asked questions about where they are and all this. And everyone just has their mindset on the Super Bowl. So the Cowboys are worried about individual statistics and Miles Sanders. How about this with this head coach? He is outrageous. His personality's loud. When you think you clinch a playoff spot, maybe you would see some of that. Instead, it's all business. It's
not what
funny.
He wants.
It's funny.
But it's not what they want. They want to higher goals. I think that's what you want to hear from a head coach. I don't know about you guys, but that's perfect for me hearing that from Sirianni. That's what you want to hear. I want to be on a jet with Tyrone and you going out to Arizona. And Jen.
Yep, absolutely. No. It's funny you say that. This is like where the guy and the girl are friends. And the guy inevitably wants to not just be friends. Because, like, come on.
Yeah.
And the girl's like, but what if we lose what we have now? Yeah, see, we don't care about that. We're trying to do the other stuff. He's thinking about Sirianni, the other stuff. This little made the playoffs thing to him, that's friend zone. He's not thinking about the friend zone. He wants the full thing. He's not worried about losing what they have now. Have you ever said that to a person, Jim? Ever in your life?
That means multiple.
Have you ever said it to have you ever said to somebody when that you were friends and the person might have wanted to be more that about the whole what if we lose what we have? Have you ever said that ever in your life?
Yes.
Have you ever said it to the Georgia punter?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, man.
Figured we'd ask her that. I mean, it's a Georgia punter.
Oh.
6-1-0.
Makes no sense to anybody but us
6-3-2-0-9-7-5. But that's the point. The Eagle, it's just to enjoy it right now. I think it is now us to enjoy. And that quarterback, like, I know it's a team game, but they're winning because of the quarterback. Man, is that quarterback playing. Like, Jalen Hurts is playing at a level. You mentioned the MVP. And yes, but even if he for some reason doesn't get that, look at what he's doing early in the game. It's passing the ball. He's making the right read every time. He's taking care of the football, but still taking chances. He's not just dinking and dunking, because that can be monotonous. All of a sudden, the safeties walk up. The offense still has big play potential, has the short yardage potential. It has all the stuff, because he's doing everything right now.
Here's a great way to look at this. Put yourself in a defensive coordinator of the Bears right now. What the hell do you do?
Hope for mistakes. No, I'm serious. Hope that the weather or something makes them make mistakes.
You hope for like a blizzard.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, because you can't stop this team. You're not going to stop them.
No, and you would think, okay, in this era, you don't want guys to throw the ball on you as explosive, so maybe you try and take away the pass and let them run, right? Just in theory.
Right.
Yeah, good luck with this offensive line. You stopping this offensive line?
No.
Who is? Nobody.
Right, and if you don't get home, now the old knock used to be able to blitz them. Last year, you could blitz them. Now you blitz him, he's killing you if you do that. If you can't get there with four, then he has a bunch of time to survey better receivers. And then if you win, if he makes one guy miss,
he's gone.
He's gone. There's just right now. It's just this is. This is glorious.
I got to throw even more credit his way. That quarterback draw that he scored on yesterday. Mm-hmm. I mean, I call it a quarterback draw.
It was a design run.
It looked more like a design run.
Yeah.
I mean, to me, picking that hole and understanding that, I got 10 yards there easily. Boom, touchdown. You cannot stop this stuff.
Right, because it wasn't super obvious. At the top of the drop, a lesser quarterback runs to the wrong. He gets there, does the little cut to the right, and then boom, puts his foot in the ground.
Think if Daniel Jones tried that. He would have been leveled about the four. Right.
And he's an athletic guy, but he's a different type of runner in that if you don't get him outside, he's not doing anything. This is a middle run, sees the linebacker, gets him with the hard step, boom, into the end zone, untouched.
You have a running back. An extra running back.
Who's playing full court. This is glorious. Let's talk to Malcolm in Georgia as we go to the phones. You're on 97.5 The Fanatic. How you doing, Malcolm?
I'm doing well. How you doing, everybody?
Man, doing well. Can't be doing better than this in a regular season.
Hey, listen, I just wanted to come on and just say that it is a joy watching the Eagles play football. In my 60 years of watching it, I don't think I've been more pleased with sitting down and taking in an Eagles football game, you know, and watching it on TV and just seeing. I'm so pleased with the offense. I just wanted to say that last run by Miles Sanders, my wife and I, we're sitting there watching this. And when that play takes off and you see the guard and the tackle pull and you see Miles take his time and navigate through the hole, and then all of a sudden you just see the thing bust open and he's like, he just slips right through it and dashes on into the end zone. I mean, it was a thing of beauty. And then when they go back and they show the replay and they show Calcaterra, he takes out that guy. I mean, it was just so pretty. When the play took off, we're sitting there. We go, oh, because we just see this thing develop. And it was just a thing of beauty. And this offense is beautiful. I'm happy with the defense. I don't know if I could have said that 3 or 4 weeks ago. I'm one of those guys that wanted pressure. But I'm looking at what they're doing now, and I'm very well satisfied with it. And it's just wonderful, just seeing what's happening. And the thing about this Eagles team is, all three things. If we come on this every week and we want to pick out things, and they're noticeably bad, but they seem to fix it. I mean, it's like the special teams. I like what they're doing there with Boston's making the change to Boston Scott.
Oh, yeah, for kicks. Yeah. Malcolm, thanks for the call, buddy. Just didn't want to run out of time. Other than Sipos's performance, I was very pleased with almost basically everything. It's just, I mean, this is one of those times where it's like Like, if there's traffic and then you see, like, an ambulance, you're not glad anybody got hurt, but at least you know why you were in traffic. It's those times when you're in traffic and you get to where the traffic breaks and there's nothing. And you're like, I sat in that traffic for nothing. You Sipos, that's what, he's traffic right now.
You could have had the punter for the Giants, though. Could have been a lot worse.
It's true.
Well,
at least he picked it up and tried to run with it.
See, that's the problem, is he wasn't running. 610-632.
Tiptoeing through the tulips.
0975. More of your phone calls at the Nick Sirianni Press on the other side. And Football Monday on the Fanatic is presented by Pierce Phelps. Whatever it takes, go to nopaybryant.com. We'll be right back.
The best show ever. On 97.5, The Fanatic.
Word of the day is glorious. Talking about the Eagles and trying to enjoy it, because I hear some people out there that need the drama. That need it. And we all know people like that, men and women, who strive off the drama. Not anybody here, but people.
Oh, I love drama.
Jen. You know,
I try to stay away from it, but I love it.
Jen, see, all right. You know, sometimes a woman might just say hi to your man. That doesn't mean that she wants him.
Great point.
She might have just said hi.
No, I get
and
that.
Here you go, going.
Stirring the pot.
Stirring the pot. Yeah. Well, we don't want that.
Yeah. We get home and it's like, hey, you know, why was she looking at you that way? Well, I don't know. And then now you're making something out of nothing.
That's what women do best.
Just because you want the drama.
Making something out of nothing. Drama.
Then, we're getting back to the phones. Then there'll be a woman who likes the guy. You like the guy for a reason. Then you're shocked that someone else would like the guy for that same reason.
Yep.
Like, you like him for whatever reason. Then someone else likes the guy for the same reason. It's like, oh, my goodness, you must be doing something wrong. Or I'm doing something correct. The same way I got you would be attracted to someone else.
You're very true.
But rather than just accept that, no, Jen Scordo, no. Let's have drama.
Of course.
See? So now the Eagles are an attractive football team.
That's right.
The most attractive, the best looking, the tallest, most handsome one
most
in
swagger.
All of the land. Got the best car, got the biggest house, on the biggest side of town, on the biggest hill. Everything you could possibly want, kind of like Ric Flair. All right?
It's so hard for me to sit back here looking
today.
At a guy out here hollering my name.
My name.
Last year, I spent more money on spilled liquor in bars from one side of this world to the other than you made.
I spent more money on spilled liquor than you made. That's the Eagles right now. There is no need to have any of this drama. We should just be able to enjoy it as is. We don't need the drama, in my opinion, to be able to enjoy this football team.
They're doing it without Dallas Goedert, too. Imagine when that gets mixed
week.
Back in.
Well, no, I mean,
unfortunately, we do have some punter drama.
Oh.
Yeah, so Tom Pelissero is tweeting out that Sipos is out indefinitely with a lower leg injury suffered when he scooped and blocked a punt. So,
well, I'm not glad that he's hurt, but at least now it makes sense why he couldn't hold. Because if he wasn't hurt, then it not coming out the hole would have made sense. So not glad that he's hurt at all. Makes more sense now why Covey had to hold, because it didn't make sense at the time. Like, well, hold on. But the fact that they, again, lower leg injury. So they don't know a day later what it is?
They know exactly what it is.
It does say here he is still undergoing some tests.
So wait a minute.
Well, we got a presser coming up soon, so that's going to be the book answer right there.
Still undergoing tests. Philly will need to add a punter.
All right. Well, let's go.
He's still undergoing the test. They know something's up because he's going to be out.
Right.
So just keep it real for once. Well, but all right.
He's the punter. Just tell us what's wrong with him.
Right. I mean, he's kind of important.
The advantage for the Bears, though. Come on now.
Yeah, they'll know.
Can't give them the advantage.
Yeah, my goodness. All right. Let's go back to the phones. Jose at Gilbertsville. You're on 97.5 The Fanatic. Hello, Jose.
What's going on, Tyrone?
Man, I couldn't be getting any better than I'm doing right now.
What a glorious football team we have, what a glorious quarterback we have, what a glorious offensive we have, what a glorious defense we have. This is like that one present you've been asking Santa Claus for all month long, and come Christmas morning, you get that present. It's like the moment of the season.
Mm-hmm. Like that
this
PlayStation.
Is like that, Yeah, this is like that toy that you when it's time to go to bed, Christmas, you know, Christmas, the day after Christmas, whatnot, you take it to bed with you. You play with it all month long, all year long. You tell your friends about it. You brag about it. This is just glorious, our football team that we have right now. I love what I'm seeing across the board. I just can't wait for these playoffs to start. I can't wait for us to fly out to Arizona and get this Super Bowl win. I can't wait for Jalen Hurts to be the MVP. It's just glorious all around, man. Glorious all around. I love it.
As far as regular seasons go, it really doesn't get any better than this. It doesn't get better than this. As far as regular season, we know about the playoff business, but I'm not going to be one of these people fast-forwarding. Each week, each day, I'm going to soak this all in and not just worry about the destination when the glory, when the journey is this sweet.
I am in an awe moment. It's just beautiful to see what Howie Roseman has done to build this team. I think it's better than the 2017 year team.
This team is just
blowing people out of the water. I can't wait till the playoffs to start. I mean, we still got a couple games we got to, you know, pay attention to, but I'm ready to be partying on Broad Street. Hopefully, we're sitting there and enjoying a beautiful, glorious parade.
Yep, and thanks for the call, Jose. That's what we're going to be doing. 610-632-0975. That's where I'm going to be at Broad Street. It's just maybe I set up some sort of solar tent or something.
Oh, you're going solar.
Well, you set up like the clear plastic.
Yeah.
Because it's chilly. That was the only bad part about the last parade was it was cold.
Well, maybe you can get so cold. Liquored up.
Oh, it's February.
Even the liquor didn't
help. I mean, it's going to be February.
That's what I mean. It's going to be cold. So you get one of those clear plastic joints and the sun comes in and it stays. So now you're outside, you can see, but it's toasty inside. I already got one in my Amazon wish list.
Oh, you have it.
I didn't buy it. I'm saying it's in the wish list.
I like that move by
so
you.
So I'm going to wait.
It's a little heat fan.
Because I don't want to buy it now because that would be too presumptuous.
Agree.
But as soon as they lock up that first buy, the only buy in the conference, that's when I pull the trigger on the purchase. Then I'm out there. It folds up real small. So getting there, taking whatever I got to get to the parade, no big deal. I put it out there. It's not very big. And now I'm warm. While watching the parade.
Well, you bring yourself a porta-toilet, too? You ever see those porta-tents?
I actually have seen them.
Yeah, I know. I got places along Broad Street. I have multiple places along Broad Street where I can...
Now you can peek your head in.
Yeah, I'm good, yeah.
Lucky you. I mean, I might be out there struggling.
Nah, we're all taken care of.
Oh, nice. What happens if someone's like, hey, Ty, can I get under there?
No.
No. So it's like no one else is allowed. This is my personal.
I mean, whoever. I mean, maybe... Your wife. You know, yeah, but I'm saying, like, anybody else, no.
You're not going to stand under there and have your wife on the outside.
Right, that's what I'm saying, but everybody else, no, you can't. Of course not.
Okay.
What's wrong with you? Right. Should have bought your own tent. You knew they were going to the Super Bowl. Why didn't you make preparation?
Should have had it in your Amazon cart.
Right, what did you, they sell these. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that'd be on them.
I do love this, though, about Hassan Reddick. Guy's playing unbelievable at this moment. It's like this team is so detailed right now, and they're doing everything so well. You set the edge, and then that allows Daniel Jones to run in a certain lane, and here's Fletcher Cox, who's just picking you up and throwing you down with, like, one hand. He's spinning you on the ground. It's just setting the edge. Everything they do, it just seems like it's perfect.
That's why they're so good, because they know each other. They know exactly where everybody's supposed to be on every play, and nobody gets out of their quote-unquote lanes. I mean, when you really think about it, I think it was Brandon Graham was talking about that yesterday, where we each know what each other's jobs are, and it makes it that much easier on each individual. And you know what? Ball comes your way or the play comes your way, you take care of business, and that's exactly what this team has done.
Three sacks for Brandon Graham.
Dude, he's coming off of an Achilles, and he's like 97 years old in football.
And now
he's
I'm like, you beast. Know what? He is under contract for another year. I'm like, you might as well bring him back. I mean, you may as well. I mean, he's still playing at a high level. If
this
it doesn't cost too much.
Right.
This right here, though, him and Fletcher Cox and those guys playing well are part of the reason why I'm not overly panicked with some of the contracts with the Phillies. Old is not old the same way for everybody.
And it's not like it used to be. If this was 10 years ago, yeah, this team would be aging. But they're not. It's not like that anymore.
No, the world has changed. Before the presser, Evan and Redding. You're on 97.5 for that.
What's going on, guys? How everybody doing on this Victory Monday?
I mean, it doesn't get much better than this, Evan. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Couldn't be better. Great time to be an Eagles fan.
Mm-hmm.
My one point that, you know, I want to make before Sirianni speaks is, which breakout season was more impressive. Carson Wentz from 2016 to 2017 in the Super Bowl year and his, you know, should have been MVP year before he got hurt, or Jalen Hurts from last year to this year.
Personally, I think it's Hurts because when looking at Wentz, we looked at everything he had with his skill set, the big arm, big body, and we knew it was in there, but then he put it together. With Hurts, there was legitimate conversation about the arm talent, the strength, and all that stuff, and he was able to kind of push forward and deliver.
Yeah, it's Hurts because Wentz looked he looked a part as a rookie more than Hurts looked last year in that the string of quarterbacks they got to play last year always made you question it. But now what he's doing and the jump is unbelievable. And Wentz was able to move very well. And then all of a sudden he wasn't moving so well. Hurts has obviously that mobility, but he's so smart about how he uses that mobility. And flat out, he's a smarter football player than Carson Wentz.